This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to explain how to find the surface area of a right prism. So let's make sure we understand what a right prism is. I've got a picture here with two prisms. Both of the prisms have pentagons as their bases. And for both of the prisms, the pentagons, the two bases, are congruent. They're identical. And they're parallel to each other. The difference is this. For the prism on the left, each of the faces, each of the lateral faces, the sides, is a rectangle. So when that's the case, you've got what's called a right prism. For this other prism that I have, the faces are not rectangles. If the faces aren't all rectangles, you've got what's called an oblique prism. In this video, we're just going to deal with the surface area of right prisms, like this one I have here on the left. Okay, so here's the first example. In this case, I've got a rectangular prism. It's a right prism. And its height is 7 inches. And the two bases are rectangles that have dimensions of 3 inches by 4 inches. We want to find the surface area. That's going to mean the surface area for the two bases plus the four lateral sides. So we can think of ourselves as building this prism. We would have to have the two bases. So we're going to need two pieces of, let's say, cardboard that are 3 inches by 4 inches. And then we'll need the four sides. So we could make those four sides by having, let's take the first side, the one on the left. That's going to be a piece of cardboard, let's say 7 inches by 3 inches. And if we have a large piece of cardboard, we could draw the next side right onto it, right next to that first one. Let's use this front side that we have here. And that's going to be 7 inches by 4 inches. All of these four lateral sides will be 7 inches high. Okay, let's go over to the right side. That's 3 inches by 7 inches, so we'll add that on to this. So we've got 3 more inches. And then we've got that back, that's 4 inches wide and 7 inches high. So it looks like what we're dealing with in terms of a formula for this would be the area for the two bases. So the surface area for this whole prism, the surface area is going to be 2 times the surface area for the bases. I use a capital B for surface area of the base. And then I'm going to want to have the surface area of these four sides that I have. But if I join the four sides together, I get a nice rectangle. That rectangle has dimensions that are 7 inches, that's the height, times 3 plus 4 plus 3 plus 4. Well, that 3 plus 4 plus 3 plus 4 is really the perimeter of the rectangle, the perimeter of the base. 3 inches plus 4 inches plus 3 inches plus 4 inches. So we can say that the formula for the surface area of a prism is going to be 2 times the surface area of the base plus the height times the perimeter of the base. So let's take our actual dimensions and plug them into this formula. We'll have 2 times, well, the base, the surface area of the base is 3 by 4. So that's 3 times 4. The height is 7 inches. And the perimeter was 3 plus 4 plus 3 plus 4 inches. Let's work that out. 3 times 4 is 12, and 2 times 12 is 24. And I've got to add 3 plus 4 is 7 plus 3 more is 10 plus 4 more is 14, and 7 times 14 is 98. So I've got 24 plus 98. I'll just add those together. I'll get 122. We were dealing with inches, So these are going to be square inches. Okay, so we just added the surface area for the two bases plus the height of the prism times the perimeter of the base. Let's look at a different shape prism. Here I've got a triangular prism, and nicely enough, the triangle, the two bases, is a right triangle. So let's take the formula we used. The surface area is 2 times a capital B for the surface area of the base, plus the height times the perimeter. Okay, let's plug our numbers in. So the surface area is 2 times the surface area of the base. Well, if this is a right triangle, then its surface area is going to be 4 times 3, the base times the height, divided by 2. So I'm going to have 2 times that surface area, 3 times 4, divided by 2, plus the height. The height is 8 inches. And we want to multiply that by the perimeter. Well, the perimeter is the perimeter of the base, which is 3 plus 4 plus 5. Okay, so now we've got all our numbers filled in. We just have to do the math. 3 times 4 is 12. 12 divided by 2 is 6. And I'm going to, that's, so 6 is the surface area for each of the bases. I'm going to multiply that by 2 because there's two bases. So 2 times 6 is 12. Then I want 8 times the perimeter. The perimeter was 3 plus 4 is 7, plus 5 more is 12. So that's 8 times 12. Now I've got 12 plus 8 times 12 is 108. And 108 plus 12 is 120. I'm sorry, 8 times 12 is 96. Let's do that again. So that's 12 plus 96. 12 plus 96 is 108. There we go. Okay, and don't want to forget square inches. Okay, so for any right prism, your formula is going to be the surface area is 2 times the surface area of a base. The bases are identical, so we multiply that by 2, plus the height of the prism times the perimeter of a base. And as with a lot of other formulas, you can memorize this if you want to, or you can just realize how we derived it, how we figured it out by just imagining what it would take to make one of these prisms, and then you can make this up as you go along. So it's a matter of either memorizing it or remembering the logic of it and just recreating it. Okay, that's it for now. Take care. I'll see you next time.